Finally, there is a lot of advanced mobile device management in the Plus plan. So this would be specific to businesses, like maybe you're a trade business, you've got a bunch of people on the road, and you've got a bunch of corporately managed devices, and you want to make sure that they are well managed. And so you can do things like push down apps, you can set restrictions, you can set policies. There is still basic device management available on the starter and the standard plans, but really the full suite of mobile device management is on the Plus. And so remember, these plans are designed, the business plans are all designed for organizations from 1 to 300 employees. And that's really gonna serve a lot of businesses when you've got the, let's say, the challenges of a growing business, managing a fleet of devices, managing, you know, your team and staff in different locations and potentially speaking different languages. Something like Google Vault becomes absolutely critical anytime you're above certain revenue level, and then you're, I think it's $2 or $3 million a year, you're then bound by Australian privacy principles. And so you need to make sure that you're protecting the data and the personal information of everyone that you're working with, clients, customers, people inside the business, people outside the business, any data that comes into your possession, you've got to make sure that that's compliant. PCI DSS, which is the credit card certification and compliance. You got to make sure that you're on top of that as well. And so these plans, I think, are a pretty good fit. I really like that Google have adjusted these to what I believe is a good value proposition based on different, you know, segments of the market and what businesses are up to. And look, I'm not towing the party line here. I think these are great plans. I think the Business Plus could do with a few more things to really make it a bit more compelling. We'll see what Google develops there. But definitely the standard plan has had some awesome, awesome new features added to it, which I'm really glad to see. So we have a question here. If the 2 terabytes on pooled users include shared drives, and the answer to that is yes. So currently, because the G Suite business plan is a unlimited storage plan, Google haven't counted the storage in shared drives, and they haven't counted the storage in individual drives on business plans. However, now that is changing to a pooled user setup. Yes, you will have to use a standard plan. And if you're using shared drives, they are going to count towards the data storage. Remember, the storage is pooled across the organization, so you're going to be able to see what each user is using and then what's been put into the shared drives, and that'll count towards your total pooled storage. Another one here from Mark has said, has MDM been removed from Business Standard? Mark, I don't know exactly what it's going to look like. I can share a help guide on that below this video. The business mobile device management on the basic plan and the standard plan is basically the same, and there's advanced mobile management on the Plus plan. I don't know exactly what each one of those are going to look like just yet. All we've been told by Google is that I think things like pushing down apps, I think managing policies on the devices, also managing endpoints like Windows devices. Google is starting to let you, you know, connect your Google account to Windows machines. I believe they're going to be at least all saved for Plus. Some of them may even be bumped up to the enterprise plans only. The good news is with the enterprise plans is there's no minimum on how many users that you purchase. If you're a smaller business and you require some really advanced features around device management, you may choose to bump up to an enterprise plan, and they start pretty reasonably on the pricing. They've got 3 tiers there now and similar kind of pricing model. But if you have a specific need around mobile device management, send it over to our team, and we will be able to help out as much as possible there. So let's talk enterprise. I'm not going to share all of the information because I'm not sure if I'm allowed to share it publicly. But what I can say is that there are 3 tiers in enterprise. They start from $12 Australian per month. There are 2 more tiers above that. And they can be quite flexible in that you can mix and match those as long as you meet a minimum requirement of users on a particular plan. The most basic plan, which is called Essentials, doesn't include Gmail and calendar. And what that is designed for is, workers who may be on the road, who just need access to documents in Google Drive, but they don't need their own mailbox. So that's what the Essentials plan is. Basically, it doesn't have Drive, doesn't have calendar. That's the one starting at $12 a month. And that's designed for those kind of frontline workers who may need access to secure apps, may need access to forms, may need access to documents, worksheets, procedure guides, those kind of things. I'm not sure if Google Sites is included in that or not, but they're the kind of things that are included in the Essentials plan. The standard plan is pretty equivalent to what the current enterprise plan is, with a few bits and pieces missing in there. But that gives you more access to Google Meet for larger meetings, data loss prevention, which is Google's advanced security capturing data in Google Drive or capturing data in email that's potentially sensitive and stopping it before it's allowed to be shared. shared outside the organization, or even creating policies that can quarantine information if it's sensitive and potentially going to disappear outside the organization. So AppSheet Pro is a recent acquisition by Google, and it's basically a codeless app development environment. And what that allows you to do is to create apps. So that's useful for large organizations that are wanting to develop their own apps internally, but not have to completely rely on external sources to help out with that. So that's Google Workspace. I've taken you through the new plans, the new families of plans, the business family and the enterprise family. And if you're interested in any discounts before that January 15 rolls around, then I'd recommend you get in touch with our team and we will be able to help you out getting connected. So if you want to do that, jump onto itgenius.com/chat. You can chat to someone straight away, or if you prefer email, you can drop us an email as well. And our team will be very happy to set up a call with you, review your account. If you're interested in transferring your licenses to a billing relationship with us, there is no additional cost, but you will get access to some pretty cool exclusive discounts there. And if you are transferring your licenses in, we'll actually give you free course access to some of our courses in Genius Academy. We've got an amazing G Suite Getting Started course, which is great for you and for your staff as well. When you're hiring someone new and you want to onboard them, you want to get them up to speed nice and quickly, then using our Google Classroom to train your staff is going to help you with your HR onboarding. So I'd thoroughly recommend you check that out. If you're interested in details, jump on the link below and have a chat to our team. But I'm keen to hear what your thoughts are. Please let me know in the comments below. Do you think the brand change is a good change? Do you like the new logos? Personally, I'm not a fan of the new logos. I think they might kind of grow on me, but we'll see how it goes. I think overall, considering the fact that most of our customers in the small business space are already on the standard plan, I think it's a pretty good value proposition for Google to rejig it, add a lot of, you know, really important new features like the meet recording to that plan, and then give options for businesses who may be interested in upgrading to go along other avenues. So I'm pretty happy about this change. I do like that there's more choice, particularly for enterprise customers as well, because we've had enterprise customers who have said, hey, we've got 50 people on the road, or we've got 100 people on the road. You know, what do we do with their licensing, not wanting to pay $35 per person per month for that? We could do the whole rigmarole of enterprise discounting and, oh, well, we discount it to this much, and if you get this many users, blah, blah, blah. This just makes it all a whole lot simpler with more flexible options, which I like very much. If you're not already a member of our Facebook group, which if you're watching the live, you already are, but if you're watching this on YouTube and you are not yet a member of our G Suite community, what was G Suite community, now Google Workspace community on Facebook, then jump on the link down there below. It's free to join, full of business owners. You'll get access to our live videos when we record them live, get access to Q&A with myself, and of course, other exclusive content that we have there in the group. Go ahead and join it. If you're a business owner and you're using Google Workspace right now, then there's no reason not to join. Till next time, catch you in the next video. Take care.